So here we go, guys. Hey, my name is Mel, and I am a personal trainer and a behavior change specialist. I took a week or two off, but I am back into my routine of doing lives at 2 o'clock. Today's topic kind of seems vague, but really it is down to the foundation, the fundamentals, because it just needs to be said. I do run a program, and yeah, I can give you tips and tricks all day to help you lose weight, but the honest truth is not everyone is ready to lose weight. Not everyone is ready for the commitment. Not everyone is really serious. So we are gonna talk about what it takes to be really serious about weight loss, and then you can decide if you are one of those people. So this topic is, I thought, might actually make some people not so happy to hear. A lot of it is because we say we want to lose weight and we say we want to get healthier, but when it really comes down to it, we want it to be easy. We don't really want to change much. And a lot of people tend to make a lot of excuses. So number one, for weight loss, you need to be in a no excuse zone. You can come up with excuses all day, but the more important thing is to question how to overcome those excuses, not to ramble the excuses off, because honestly, excuses are just that, excuses. You can either lose weight or you can have excuses. You cannot have both. So I hear a lot about, you know, making weight loss easy and intuitive eating and, you know, doing easy workouts at home and getting great results. But the honest truth is that if you're trying to lose weight, you can't get lax. Like, you can't just like relax into it so much. You have to be very intentional. You have to have a plan. You have to be really consistent. So something like, if you're really, really serious about weight loss, you can't go out to eat 3 to 4 times a week. You just can't do it. And if you think you can, then you are not serious enough about weight loss. I'm not saying you can't go out to eat. It's just it's going to be nearly impossible for you to have those kind of habits and to lose weight. Because how did you get to the place where you're at? Probably going out to eat and not watching what you're eating and partaking and just not being very conscious of those choices. So if you think that you can lose weight and still have those same habits, it's not gonna work out, and you're gonna get very upset. You're gonna lose your motivation, and it's just not gonna work. So if you are really serious about losing weight, now yes, when you're in a maintenance phase, you can go out to eat, you can do things like that, but when you are seriously trying to lose weight and you are still going out to eat 3-4 times a week, going to other places, not being in control of your food, you are not going to be able to do it. It's just that simple. So you have to either decide, I'm going to get serious about weight loss, or I'm going to keep perpetuating these same unhealthy habits that got me to where I'm at. So again, and it can be anywhere. Like if you are not in control of what you're eating, you're not going to be able to lose weight. Nutrition is like most of the problem. It's like 80%, 90%. So if you can't find a way to get control of your nutrition and the food that is coming into your body, you're not gonna be able to lose weight. But that also comes with planning. So if you are at home and you have no healthy food in your house, you are gonna eat junk. You know every single week that you need to eat healthy food. If you are not willing to plan to go to the grocery store to have healthy food, healthy meals, healthy snacks, then you are not going to be able to lose weight. You're not serious enough about the process. Simple things with nutrition. Okay, so it doesn't have to really be a huge deal. Like, you don't have to count your macros. You don't have to do any really complicated math. There's easy things you can do. One thing is obviously increasing your fruits and vegetables and removing processed foods. If you want to continue to eat, you know, cereal and crackers and chips, and again, it's going to be very hard. Are you really serious enough to make the changes that you need to see your weight go down so that you can be healthier? If you want to do something like intuitive eating, I have some people who are like, I don't want to track, I just want to eat and lose weight. Okay, so at some point, yeah, you might be able to do that, but I would say in the beginning, it's not going to happen for you. Intuitive eating means that you have to have that intuition. So if you have no idea what you're eating, you have no idea the calories that are going in, the calories that you're burning, your BMR, if you don't have any of that information, it's very hard to be intuitive about it. So if you're unwilling to do any kind of tracking in the beginning, it is gonna make weight loss a lot more difficult. And the thing is if you're serious. So if you're serious, you would be willing to track your food. Maybe not forever, not everyone needs to, because you start to get more of an idea, intuitive, and you kind of get a feeling for your body again. You start realizing, you know, and being more in tune with your hunger signals, and you know, portion size and the kinds of foods that you eat. Then you can do more intuitive eating. But in the beginning, no, if you're not willing to track for at least a few weeks, then you're probably not serious about weight loss. And then the other thing is working out. So for weight loss, now men and women are a little bit different with this, and I go into the whole hormones thing, but even if we go above and beyond that, so guys, your weight loss is gonna be pretty much solely like food, and you really won't be able to work that off so much, because guys already have so much muscle mass that their metabolism's already fast. So the workouts really aren't going to do as much. They will, but not as much as women. For women, lifting weights and moving is so crucial, because we don't start off with all that muscle. So the more muscle, the more working out, the and things that you can do, it really will make a huge difference in your ability to lose weight. But the thing is consistency. So again, I'm gonna go back up to the top with the excuses. So you need to be consistent with your workouts. If you work out one day a week this week, and next week you work out 3 times a week, and then there's, say like you're in Wisconsin and there's a snowstorm and you don't work out all week, then you're not serious about weight loss. Because if you're making it to work, if you're doing all these other things, then you should be getting your workout in, if that is one of your main goals. So if you're serious, you need to have a serious plan for being consistent. You need to be lifting weights. You need to be, you know, incorporating progressive overload, which is basically, you know, lifting more each week so that you are actually challenging your muscles. Cardio is fine, but it's not gonna help you lose weight. You'll get to a point and then you're gonna plateau. What women really, really, really need, if they're serious about weight loss, is lifting weights in a progressive overload manner. Cardio is like the third most important thing when it comes to this. So it's nutrition for women specifically, weightlifting, and then cardio. And even if you're not big into cardio, like I know a lot of people are all about high intensity interval training and, you know, boot camps and things where they're sweating their asses off, it's not necessary for weight loss. The most important thing for weight loss is consistency. If you are not someone who likes those intense classes, I'm one of them. I prefer to dance, I prefer to walk, I like to do things like that. You can do things like tracking your steps. So, you know, if you have a tracker, you can see how many steps you're getting on a daily basis. That can be your motivation. It's all about consistently moving, consistently being active, and just knowing, you know, how many calories your body is burning or how much you can eat on a regular basis. That is gonna help you get serious about your weight loss, because this doesn't work. The more consistent you can be, the better. So if you are not getting to the gym on a consistent basis, you know, I would say minimum of 3 times a week, you need to have other things in place, whether it is doing a workout video at home, having some weights. If you do things like me where I like to dancing at home, like you can pop in some, there's free stuff on YouTube everywhere. You can dance at home. I used to do that on vacation. I would take my own playlist and literally just listen to it and dance by myself. And that would be my at-home workout, or whatever is you know, whatever you like the most. Again, so cardio, if you don't like cardio, you don't have to do it intensely. It's more consistent. Whatever you're gonna do consistently, that is gonna be the best cardio for you, because again, it's all about nutrition and weightlifting. So you just need to get consistent. Those are my main things when it comes to getting serious about weight loss, guys. Again, I can give you tips. Like, you can drink apple cider vinegar, or you can, you know, bump up your protein or take this supplement, or you can not eat after a certain time of the day, or you can do intermittent. There's all of these like little tips that you can do, but honestly, none of them are gonna work long term. None of them are gonna get you the results that you wanna get if you don't realize if you're actually, sorry, my hair is dirty and frizzy. keep on messing with it. But nothing is going to get you consistent weight loss results if you are not serious. So first, if you're serious, you will find a way to get rid of all the excuses. Don't use excuses. You need to come up with a plan. You can't be, number two, lax about it. You can't just relax into it and it's not just going to happen. Weight loss is something that's very intentional. You have to plan things. You have to be consistent. Three, you can't just eat out and drink 3, 4, 5 times a week because the calories add up. If you want to lose a pound a week, that's 3,500 calories. If you are not eating, if you have a deficit of 500 calories a day, that's about a pound a week. But if you are eating really well for 3 days of the week, but then you overeat 1,000 calories 3 times a week, you're not gonna lose weight. And it's almost impossible to track if you're going out to eat. You can make healthier choices, but most of the time when I'm talking to people, they're not making necessarily the healthiest choices. They are partaking in, you know, meals that have a lot of calories. They have no idea what's in there. They're drinking alcohol, which makes you actually store fat around your stomach. You don't even metabolize it. And normally when you're drinking, you make poor decisions and your decision-making skills kind of go out the window. So if you're doing that more than once a week, it's nearly impossible to lose weight. Nutrition, that is literally the most important part of weight loss. So if you are, you know, not committed to eating whole foods, fruits and vegetables, tracking so that you know what is coming in your body and what you are burning outwardly, you are not gonna be able to lose weight. It's just not gonna happen for you. And working out, if you can't consistently get to the gym, and if you can't, then having a backup plan, if you can't make that happen on a consistent basis, you are not going to be able to lose weight. You're not gonna, you're not quite serious enough. Now, that's okay if that's where you are right now. It doesn't mean that you won't ever be able to lose weight, but you do have to, at some point, come to the realization that you're the only one that can make this happen. You can work with, you know, personal trainers and coaches and nutritionists, and you can take classes. You can do all of these things, but if you aren't in that state of mind where you're really taking control of your own actions and getting serious, you're just setting yourself up for disappointment, and you're gonna lose that motivation. And the thing is that you can do it. You just have to get to the point where there is no plan B, and I've talked about this before. There's no plan B. No excuses. Be prepared. Realize that the decisions that you make is gonna depend on what's gonna depend on whether you lose weight or you don't lose weight. So you can't count on anyone else. You are the only one who's gonna be in charge of that. So just as a nice friendly reminder, if you are serious about weight loss, those are the things that you really want to tune into and make sure that you're getting them done every single day, every single week. I am on another note. I am onto my second day of my flush prep. Basically, all I'm doing is taking malic acid. If you're interested in my liver and gallbladder flush, send me a message and I will send you the document that I put together so that you can join me. Again, I'm just taking these supplements. Or what you can do is drink 32 ounces of apple juice every day. Or you can actually do apple cider vinegar up until Friday, and then you wanna do a low-fat diet Friday and Saturday, and then Saturday you have some Epsom salt drinks that you are going to drink, and grapefruit and olive oil are the other ingredients that you need, and it's basically that simple. So join me. You can either do it this time, you can do it next time with me, or you can just be a few days behind. You can do this on your own. It really does, you don't really need me, but message me and I will give you the information. On another side note, if anyone has any advice, I am bored of this. So I am looking for someone who might be able to do some nails. So if you have any recommendations, I know this is really off topic, but I'm looking to do like long, pointy, bright colored nails. Non-toxic would be best. If anyone knows someone who does makeup, I don't know how to do makeup. I'm bored. I'm going to start doing some crazy things with my hair, maybe. I'm thinking some colorful wigs. I don't know. I'm bored and I need a change. So if anyone has any recommendations of like really good nail people, people who know anything about makeup. I don't know anything about makeup. I literally have done the same makeup for my whole life. And I'm just bored with it. So if you have any recommendations, send them my way. And that's all I have for you. I hope you have a great day and I will talk to you next time. Message me with any questions about weight loss or the liver gallbladder flush that I am doing currently. And I will talk to you guys next time. Bye, guys.